Rumors spreading round in that Texas town about the shack outside the game. And you know what I'm talking about. Just let me know if you wanna go to that whole mile on the range. They got a lot of nice girls.
Hello and welcome to Sports Vision, the magazine on WTMB. Of course, Joe Palo with my friends, Bear and Fajita, and my other friend, Mike Cragen.
And as usual, right before the telecast, we're talking and prepping for the show and discussing sports.
Exactly, always.
Exactly what we need to discuss. Well, I'll tell you what, there's been a lot of sports going on here, and we have basketball with Cleveland and Ocoee, 7th grade, 8th grade, boys and girls coming up to show you, and we have a little bit of 10 and under basketball,
right.
And we have some discussing to do about number one and number two in high school wrestling coming on tonight. Soddy's coming to town.
Yeah.
And on the internet, it's all, look out, Bradley, Soddy's coming. Well, I don't know. Look out, Soddy.
Now, for the folks watching this on Saturday and Sunday, of course, Bradley
it's
would
over.
Already have beaten a you
hopefully
know,
they already have beaten him. We got
soggy days.
Several good matchups.
So
we got number one
Jay
and number two at 1:30. And, of course, I'm very interested in that match, so we'll have to see how it all come out.
Yeah, I wonder why.
But let's move on. Let's go. We're starting out with Ocoee versus Cleveland. This happened a couple of weeks ago. As you know, we had a special on the Bradley Wrestling last week, and here comes Ocoee. This is the 7th grade girls. Go ahead, Joe.
All right, here we go. 7th grade girls, Ocoee Middle versus Cleveland. Here you go. In come Cleveland 7th grade girls. And we've got pumping everybody up, getting ready to start this ball game. They clap real fast. Here we go. Ocoee strikes first. Michelle Policastro.
No, Michelle Smith right there.
Well, Policastro inside to Michelle Smith.
That's right.
There you go. That's right. Hey.
Hey.
Out front and off the glass to Cleveland. Emily Fear.
Now we're on to the Ocoee.
Right, there we go. We're moving on. Hubbard for Ocoee. Gets the bounce off a runner. She gets two. Inbound pass to Smith. Easy two for Ocoee. Cleveland's raging. Rachel Isom spots Shelly Williams inside for two. But Ocoee Sandlin off the rebound. Basket, and guess what? Foul. There you go. Cleveland's Andrews would answer. And then raging Rachel Isom with two on a run for Cleveland. Bump up in off the glass. There, it's good. Kelly Moore. More of Kelly for Ocoee from Mount Eagle. Three-point shot. Holy smokes. Moore again. 3-point this time from the other side of Mount Eagle, and she gets it in there. All right. It's Ocoee 17-13 at the half, as you can see right there. Second half action. And first blood would be Fear for Cleveland. It's good. Off inbounds, Erica Scoggins passes it, gets the ball, ties it at 17 right there. Anderson on a turnaround. Jay gives Cleveland the lead. Oh my goodness. Rachel Isom now extends it with a steal and a score right there. And raging Rachel again to Scoggins. Nice. That's not Brad though. Looks like him a little bit, about his height. Smith now stops the drop for Ocoee as she gets two. But Cleveland would outscore Ocoee 12-4 in the third. The lead is 25 there for Cleveland. They get 25. Kerry Simpson now 4-2. And watch this. Simpson, second effort off the board. Right there. Two more. All right. Off the inbounds. Third straight basket for Simpson. 28-27. Ocoee Middle. 2:55 to go in the ball game. 1 point, Ocoee lead, Moore good, Ocoee by three. And Moore again, right there. It's now a 5-point Ocoee lead. Cleveland, last ditch effort, Michelle Smith, rebounds. and Okoye would win this ball game over Cleveland seventh grade girls. Good game. Very exciting.
Great game. They've had some good ones, and they got a TVAC tournament going on as we speak this weekend. But on to the boys. Here comes Okoye out of the Cleveland dressing room, having won the first match. Second matchup, Cleveland has different ideas. Bryce Hooper leading them out right there, and Okoye without their big man, Dallin McLeod, big factor in the game, but also a big factor was Brandon Elrod as he gets two to strike first. Montez Davis now with a sweet two for Cleveland. Davis out front, watch him work. He's gonna get two more, and it's good. Now we got Okoye's Mark Gibson. He's gonna hit a runner. They call him Mr. Smooth. I guess that's Big Jacques on the eighth grade team. Chris Kugler now, he's gonna hit Bryce Hooper, and Bryce Hooper's gonna hit the shot. Two more for Cleveland. Good passing again is Davis. Now he'll hit Hooper for the shot. Elrod gonna work it inside again. Where's big Brandone with the shot? Turnaround, jumper, good. 10-8, Okoye would lead at the quarter. Gibson now, second quarter, is gonna give Okoye a 4-point lead as he gets out in front of the pack and he is lasing in right there. Davis, fast break though to Kugler. And here's Kugler out front, lead cut to two. Kugler in a crowd, watch this, nothing but black jerseys, but it doesn't matter. But Kugler with the basket, and Kugler's gonna drive through right here and after picking up the loose ball and get two more. Hooper, now it's Cleveland on a run, will fire in two, and Elrod now, he's gonna have a pretty inside move, watch this. Underneath, little spin shot, two more to break the drop for Okoye. Cleveland takes a 21-15 halftime lead to the locker room. Second half, Elrod again from outside gets the bounce. Logan Watson, watch the little man connect for three. Football pass now, Elrod to Gibson, all the way down court. Gibson picks it up, cross half court line. Nice shot, he gets fouled and he would make the extra free shot. Cleveland inbounds now, stolen. Chad Fromm steals it back. Lead.
Where is he from?
Layup. Two more, and Kugler inside to Hooper as Cleveland starts to pull away a little bit. Two more for Cleveland. Elrod, though, big man all day long, trying to answer, trying to keep him in the game.
No Gibson, pun intended.
Gibson coming now. He's going
to kid out there.
Throw it in for two as Okoye cuts it back down. Watson now finds Elrod, and it's a 6-0 run, and it's just a 2-point lead. 31-29 after three, Cleveland. Preston Scoggins, though, is going to open up a little bit. Hit a three from way outside to open up the fourth quarter. And Scoggins again, another bomb from the outside. And he's going to give them an 8-point lead like that. Elrod, though, still humming inside. Lead cut to six. Gibson's going to hit a three-pointer right here at the end of the game. But it's going to be 42-39 Cleveland as Okoye. The rally falls short. And what a game that was.
Exciting ball game.
Exciting ball game.
I'll tell you, and the rivalry continues.
All right, and here we go, Joe. Give us some middle school scores.
All right, seventh grade boys action. Cleveland over Chattanooga Christian, 44-26. And then Cleveland, we always love to say this, beats McCauley.
The privates go.
Yeah, 48-42. We like when, and you know, there's McCauley kids that live here in Cleveland.
That's
so we should.
We like those guys. Lake Forest in seventh grade girls over Madisonville, 38-9.
What?
Lake Forest girls rolling. And I believe, do we have another one? No, we're coming. Catch the ball. There it is.
Hey.
We have one more announcement. Bradley County Sports for Youth. Yes. Becky Gray says there's an annual coaches meeting Thursday, January 31st. Please be there if you're interested in that. At 7 o'clock, Bradley County Parks and Recreation. Not at the ballpark. At the Bradley County Parks and Recreation. Mark that down.
Say
Pierce
it again.
Road. More info, 472-8445. That's Becky Gray's personal home phone.
8545.
Number 8545, 8545, 472-8545.
That's Becky's home. She likes everybody to call
she
her at her house.
She likes people to call her.
Just all times of day and night.
2 to 3 o'clock in the morning.
That's what I was going to say. 3:30 in the morning, she loves when you
She's
call.
She's always
her,
up.
So,
Hey, we got to go for a commercial.
All right.
Be right back.
Do when your cash is low and you need groceries.
Check Into Cash.
That's Check Into Cash. It's a remarkable place to get instant emergency cash for a flat fee. Anytime you have an unexpected expense and need a payday advance, Check Into Cash can make it happen. You write us a personal check and you get the cash you need instantly. My checking account's low. I can't get what we need. Go to Check Into Cash. The next time you need quick cash, for whatever reason, go to Check Into Cash.
Remember how you loved going to the local diner with your parents for an authentic French dip sandwich? No, you avoided going out with your parents. You were embarrassed by their matching sweatsuits. You must be thinking of Hardee's new authentic French dip sandwich. Roast beef carved to order, covered with Swiss cheese and piled high on a freshly baked roll. Perfect for dipping in our famous au jus sauce. Might want to take Mom and Dad to the drive-thru. Try Hardee's new French dip sandwich. Hardee's, the way food ought to be.
Our buildings and employees do more than take up space. We're more than just checkbooks and loan applications. We are part of this community, just as the community is part of us. Our people have been here for years. We've worked alongside you at the Heart Walk in United Way. We reinvest both time and money, which adds to the quality of life in Bradley County. Any bank can lend money. It takes a neighbor to lend a hand. First Tennessee. All things financial, all things Cleveland, all things community. Member FDIC.
Hello and welcome back to Sports Vision, the magazine. First Tennessee, what a great place.
What a great
guy, Jim Mayfield.
Yeah, that's right, and Holly Simmons, our new contact.
Holly
out there.
Simmons.
Gotta say
Holly,
we like her now. She's a great girl.
Oh yeah, but Holly can't see this.
She's
right.
A lot prettier than Jim.
Who isn't?
That's right.
But she doesn't have a cow that gives milk.
That's true. Okay, well we got a basketball player that makes shots. Okay, that's a nice sedge way. Here
yeah,
we go.
Let's go. Here we go. This is some more middle school basketball action. Coy Middle, Cleveland, eighth grade girls, and as you can see here, they're honoring the Akoi
finale.
Senior girls, I guess, their parents, eighth grade, because they're the seniors of the Coy Middle, really, sixth, seventh, and eighth grade. Honoring their parents, look at that, how nice and sweet, everybody. A little pageantry there at the beginning.
Mr. Suter.
There's
What's
my
up?
Man.
Jim,
the magic man. All right, here we go. Jackie Pickle draws first blood for Akoi with a nice shot right there. Allison Butler would find Casey Suter, Jim's favorite daughter. 4-0, Akoi.
Only one.
Well, that's why it's a favorite. That's what I'm saying. Angie, like I would say that if you had another daughter.
Angie Wells
answers with 3-4 Cleveland. And we have Wells creates two more for Cleveland right there. Here we go. 7 straight for Cleveland on Alex Walker as she hits right there. Makes it, as we said, 7 straight. Suter works inside for 2 for Akoi Middle. Lauren Cassida with a putback for Akoi, or as Mike likes to say, Cassada.
She's a good ball player.
She is a good ball player.
I haven't said Cassada for a week.
Cleveland, Sally Craig with a jumper there. It's 12-10 Akoi at the quarter, as you can see right there. And the zeros mean there is the start of the second quarter right there. All right. See how we've been catching that lately? Second quarter action. Watch there. 2 points by Shelly Williams. Nice shot right there. All right. Look again. Because it was so nice, we're going to show it again.
Because
it's the only,
back in the quarter.
That was being nice. Kelly Logsdon calls time, and she
strategizes, pulling it out.
There we go.
Check this.
Now watch this.
She did this for an entire quarter.
This is the old North Carolina stall.
Yep.
You know, you can do this.
Well, I tell you, Kelly was trying to keep it close. She's got a very young team, a bunch of 6th and 7th.
Now, the crowd was booing.
Well, it's because it was at Okoe. The Cleveland fans thought it was a good strategy because, quite honestly, she got a young team. She's trying to keep it tight. And guess what? They went into halftime 12-12 with a very good Okoe 8th grade girls team. The favorite in the conference is Okoe. They were trying to keep it tight.
Get the defense just pressing down on them a little bit, trying to steal the ball.
Good strategy. Well, they do come out here, but basically almost the whole quarter. They come out at the end of the quarter and attack. And I'll tell you, they're passing out front. It even tires out one of the Cleveland players.
I was going to say, while they're doing this, listen, did I tell you what happened last night?
Did you hear the one about the guy that owned the blue Cadillac?
Is that the one? I thought it was a green Cadillac.
Oh, now wait a minute. I'm not going to show you that. One more pass. I had to show this one more time because even the girl out front here, she's saying, now wait a minute. I'm into this ball game.
The ball's getting heavy.
Watch this. I didn't show it. They already boinked her. Okay. I thought I was going to boink
her. Here we go. Akoi waits him out though, but just a few in the second to go, and it's 12-12.
Casey Suter, last ditch effort, and no good. 12-12 at half.
Halftime.
Because of the North Carolina stall.
It worked. I mean, it worked.
Kept her in the ball game.
Coach Logsdon.
All right.
Second half action, as you see, 12-12. Ashley Burrell hits 2, and she also gets the foul.
Nice done.
She gets the foul and the 2 points. Jackie Pickle will nail a jumper, and it's a 4-point Akoi lead. Cleveland takes it down, take a shot, right? Akoi controls the boards.
Cleveland got cold. I tell you, the reason I put that shot in there is Akoi took the lead. Here comes
Allison. There's Allison Butler, pretty spin move.
So they could not stall anymore.
Akoi by 6. You know, stalls are for horses.
That's right.
Taller Akoi controls the boards. Pickle from Cassida. 2 more. 9 unanswered points. 21-12. Okoye. Angie Wells stops the drop for Cleveland as she will split the defenders and get the shot. Cassida from Pickle, two more for Okoye. Shelly Williams hits three for Cleveland. We're moving on. Lauren Cassida again. Back. Sky Hook. There it is. Pickle out front. What's this? Two more. Look at that. Nice catch. Nice laying for Jackie Pickle. Okoye breaks it open in the third, 27-17. Wells would respond for two in the fourth for Cleveland. Pickle for three more for Okoye. And a big lead now. Okoye uses the clock a little bit more. No stall.
They decided to go out front and use it themselves.
Not bad, though.
Hey, I tell you, I applaud Kelly for the guts to do that because there's a lot of pressure to say, hey, come on, get out there.
Exactly.
You got to use your personnel.
And if you can win, you know, by just a free throw, that's all that matters. One to nothing is just as good as 100 to nothing. All right. Waning moments of the ball game. Wells will hit a three right here. But it's really a little bit too late.
That was Alex Walker.
Walker, I'm sorry. Did I say Wells? I meant Walker. 36-28, Okoye would go on to win this ball game. Good ball game.
And watch these boys now. Do they love their mamas? We're moving on to eighth grade. Same thing. Home finale. Mama gets a little flower bouquet, whatever you want to call it. Dad's right there. Watch some of these guys. They don't know. This is right here.
Mama gets a flower.
This big, our big buddy right there, Brandon.
LeBron Castle.
LeBron, and then watch this. Alex Clark. Come on, Chuck, did you teach that? Now watch this. They're just going to get more and more animated here. Here's old Big Jacques. Watch him with his mama.
Yes.
Yeah, I love you, mama. I love you. Now watch
this. You know, she still takes him over her knee and spikes
him. I don't know. Houston, we got a little problem here. This is a little too serious, I'm telling you.
All right, see?
That's all right. He's playing with his mama out front of everybody, and he's getting a good laugh, and they're having a good time, and they played a good ball game.
Look at that.
Big Jacques.
Boom.
Starts it out right here. First blood, Houston. Nice pass to him. And right here's Josh Carter. I'm telling you, that guy right there, very underestimated. Big Jock McClendon hits another one, and it's 6-0 early. Okoye, as they would run out big. Alex Goldstein finally breaks a drop. They get two, but Okoye again. Carter, Mr. Steady, hits another one, 9-2. I'm telling you, that kid is always around a basketball. Adam Hunsucker, 11-2 lead for Okoye. And that's the end of the third quarter. Okoye up big, right? It's pretty much over, you say, huh? Carter again with another basket. 13-2. Kyle Clayton, though. He's going to get mad in here, get fired up inside, starts a rally with the 2 points and the foul. A J by Phillips here is going to make it 15-4. Big Houston puts it through. And Clayton, though, he's come out and played a big ball game here. Big Kyle with two more. Goldstein is going to make it 4-0. Cleveland, as he hits the runner. Phillips is going to answer, though. Watch how high this is off. That little man knows how to put the ball up off the board. There he is. Carter again is going to hit for Okoye. And it's 19-10, Okoye. And that is going to be your halftime score. Okoye very comfortable right now. Well, I don't know. Clayton's going to get two inside to draw first blood for Cleveland in the second half. Kobe Dodd's going to lay it up. Get Kobe for two. And Clayton's going to hit the boards hard. And he's going to come up with another basket. And I'm telling you, Cleveland's pumped. Look at him now. They're coming way down. Clayton for two more to make it 8 straight for Cleveland. It's just a 1-point ball game all of a sudden. Carter now, always steady, though. When they need something big, he comes up with the shot, and he gets fouled. And he's going to hit the free throw with a friendly little
Oh!
Right there it is. Carter going to hit another one right here inside. It's 24-23. Cleveland after 3 quarters. Kobe Dodd, though. He's going to give Cleveland the lead right here. He's going to make the shot 25-24, 5 minutes to go. And they would trade punches. Carter again, as Okoye would come up with the lead right there. Carter inside, and the foul. Clayton, though, he's going to be inside. Cleveland takes the lead. Phillips, Okoye takes the lead. Carter, going to hit another one. It's going to be a 3-point lead for Okoye.
Hey!
And Big Jacques coming through. The big man,
Jacques.
Athletic in the middle. Check this guy. I mean, he can move. What a big guy.
He is. Well. Light on his feet.
35 all with a minute big 50 man. To go. And Big Jacques, key thing, hit a free throw there. 37-36, 32 seconds to go.
37-36, 32.
And here it is. Out
Remember
front,
that.
Kobe Dodd trying to work for the last shot. Shaking and baking. Gets fouled with 6 seconds. He has two free throw opportunities right here. Hey, there it is.
Pressure's
Kobe.
On. And look who's throwing in the ball. Robbie Derrick.
He worked the last shot here.
Huh.
And Kobe.
Our friend.
And then at the line, no. So it's still 37-36. He's got one to tie, no. And there's a foul, 6 seconds to go. Big Jacques McClendon Can he come down and seal it? Jacques on the other end makes the first one. Big guy does not feel the pressure. Here it is again with Big Jacques. Gonna make the other one, gonna give him a 3-point lead, 39 to 36. There's point number 39. Okoye now is gonna have a desperate three. Coming down, 5 seconds on the clock. Dodd takes the long one, just missed right there. Okoye, 39-36, as they sweep the series from Cleveland in another great basketball game, and you can tell they're excited.
Oh, yeah.
And there's your other middle school scores. Lake Forest 41-18 over Baylor. Lake Forest again with a 51-13 victory over Chattanooga Christian. And go ahead with the eighth grade boys.
All right, eighth grade boys action. Cleveland over Chattanooga Christian, 44-28. And Cleveland, as we said, always fun when we beat Macaulay, 41-36. Cleveland over Lake Forest.
They won three games this weekend. Big weekend for them. In high school basketball, right. Bradley, 45-25. Wrestling. Bradley and Cleveland. If you saw it this weekend, I hope you did. It was a great production by WTMB and SportsVision, 45-25. And in Cumberland County, Cleveland ends up beating them for the second seed, which is important. They won't meet Bradley till the finals in the region.
All right, so the region is when?
This Saturday. And it is at Ray County. So get down there and see Cleveland and Bradley. Whatever team you're for, go see them. We're going to go to commercial. We'll be right back at you.
Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic offers complete chiropractic care. Dr. Russell Smith and his friendly, dedicated staff can help relieve chronic back pain, neck pain, headaches, allergies, and also sport-related injuries. Cleveland Chiropractic Clinic has a licensed massage therapist on staff and 2 certified in-house x-ray technicians. Complete insurance filing is available and 24-hour emergency care. Phone 472-1140.
Man, I am running short on cash with the car repairs, and our wedding anniversary is coming up next week. I need some cash, fast. From where? I know. Matt was telling me about how First Southern Cash Advance helped him.
May I help you?
He just wrote them a check, and he got the cash right away. That's easy. I can do that. Then First Southern holds your check until your next payday. It's quick, confidential, and helps take care of life's really important things. First Southern Cash Advance. Cash when you need it most.
The employees of Duracell's 3 area facilities would like to give hearty congratulations to our 3 area high schools for excellence in academics and athletics. Rocker Valley High School, Cleveland High School, and Bradley Central High School. Keep up the good work, students. We are proud of you. From your local Duracell facilities, Mouse Creek Tasso, and the Corporate Distribution Center and Warehouse. At Duracell, our people are our energy.
We're back on Sports Vision, the magazine, and Duracell, good battery.
They're always there, too. They're always behind us, and they support a lot of the athletic programs.
GBC.
Thank them. Tell Cheryl Lobo.
Good battery.
Sheila, hello for us. All right, 10 and under basketball. We got to move on. Got athlete of the week to scoot in. Let's keep going here. 10 and under, we've got Michigan Avenue and Ross. And there's your lovely cheerleaders right there showing you what they can do. And we take up with the girls' game. Ross's Lauren Griffin draws first blood. And Aaron Riley's going to answer right back right here from Michigan Avenue. And Shanna Whitten right back at you for Ross as they trade punches right here. There she is. And Aisha Rock, she rocks. And she'll lay it in right here for Michigan Avenue. Good job, Aisha. Griffin,
gotta say
again.
It again.
As we go back and forth, there's
gotta
Griffin.
Say it again.
She has got the basket, 7-4.
Oh, look at the trip.
And she had a nice trip. See you next fall. And here we go, Megan McCracken with a jump shot.
Megan McCracken corn, and I don't care.
That's right, and Caitlin McChesney, she'll answer. Sarah Birchfield, Michigan Avenue, she'll answer back. And it's 11-6, Ross at the half.
11-6, Ross at the half.
Carrie Crisp from Michigan Avenue in the third quarter. 12-8 after three. We move on. Tina Garcia going to finish our little shot here.
Garcia!
Hits for Ross. 14-12. Ross with a victory.
Here we go, boys action. Justin Bond. Just call me Bond. Open it up for Ross right there with the shot. Jonathan Malone hits for Michigan Avenue. Jerry Tony. All right, for Michigan Avenue right there. Bond now will hit once again. Look at this shot. Justin Bond. Big Blake Ray for 2 on the inside. Bond again will make it as he hits it. Justin once again. 11-2 Ross after 1. And we have Reynolds now for Ross in the second quarter. He hits. And at the buzzer here, Graham Hartman, 2 for Michigan Avenue. Good shot. 13-7 at the half. third quarter, Big Blake Ray. Two more for Michigan Avenue. Bond now will hit two more points with the basket right there. Bond again.
Bond.
26-7 after three. Oh, my goodness. They go on to win 32-9. And boned with a big reason for that victory.
And let's hit some high school action here. Keep you up to date. Walker Valley and girls basketball. Whoops, Hickson. Hickson. Doubles them up. See? It's catching. Bradley. Falls. Cumberland County, 53-43. Cumberland County, good girls team down there. And here we go, boys. Action. Hickson, 75. Walker Valley, 60. Bradley beats Cumberland County, 76-58.
All right.
And hit it, Joe. We got another one.
We got girls action. And we got Cleveland beating McMinn. And a squeaker, 48-47. Tellico over Walker Valley, 53-37. Oh, goes my pen. Walker Valley beats Tellico in boys action, 53-40. And Cleveland over McMinn, 62-47. Okay?
All right.
And the rumor is Mullinax is not retiring from McMinn.
That's right. A couple other action for you. Bradley, 71-44 over Ray County. And Cleveland, 68-55 in girls action.
Over Baylor.
Over big bad Baylor, the Privates. We beat him. I like beating him. Here we go.
Here we go. Bradley over Ray County.
Bradley 75-60 over Ray and Cleveland 63-60 over Baylor as we whoop on the Privates again. Hey, listen, right here.
Always doing it.
We're going to head right to our Athlete of the Week. And you saw him playing right here. And he was a good basketball, great kid. Josh Carter. Kent Smith's looking forward to getting him. And Josh says he will.
Once again, we'd like to thank all the people over at Checking the Cash for sponsoring this segment. And we'd like to thank Tommy Caldwell at Cooper's Trophy and Plaques for giving us the plaques for this segment. Standing next to me is Josh Carter. And Josh is an outstanding 8th grade basketball player on the Ocoee Middle team. Just finished winning the conference here in the TVAC, Tennessee Valley Athletic Conference. Josh is a very steady player for them. Has one outstanding season, but in particular, two great games against Cleveland. And one of them you've just seen on the program today. Josh, 8th grade year, tell me what you're feeling. You're about ready to wind it down into the tournament. Give me your thoughts about the year and about going into this tournament.
Well, I think we've had a pretty good year this year. I mean, everybody's been stepping up and playing good, and I'm ready to win this tournament.
And is it going to be Cleveland or McCauley? McCauley probably. Who's going to be the one to beat? You won the regular season, but you still got to perform here.
I think Cleveland's going to be the hardest game for us because, you know, it's a big rivalry, and we usually don't play good against rivalries.
Also, you know, you're going to head up next year. You know, you're just about done with 8th grade. You're going to go up with the big boys here, and you're going to be running up against some good competition. A great 9th grade and 10th, you know, a whole group up there at Bradley Central. Kent Smith's got them rolling, as you know. Tell me what you're looking forward there to moving up to high school.
Well, I mean, playing against them won't do nothing but help me, so I'm ready to go up there and play with them.
And what do you think about Coach Smith? He's an awesome coach. Have you had any experience with him before?
I've met him. He's a nice guy, and I think he'll be a nice, fun coach.
When did you start your basketball career, Josh? Were you in the elementary league?
In 4th grade at North Lee, I started playing.
North Lee, and do you have a particular role model? You got somebody that's maybe, you know, influenced you heavily in your life, a parent, or just somebody that you know?
Yeah, my parents, they've always pushed me to play basketball, and they've always been there for me and helped me.
And what are their names?
Fred and Janine Carter.
Fred and Janine Carter. Well, Josh Carter's an outstanding ball player. To me, very steady influence on that Ocoee Middle team. Maybe doesn't get all the headlines, but sure does make the plays when needed. Josh Carter, outstanding basketball player. Josh, what do I do with the hat here? Well, you've got it. Okay. We'll give you the hat for being our SportsVision Athlete of the Week. We'd like you to give you a plaque, too. Try it on.
Great.
And we appreciate your time today.
Thanks, SportsVision, for making me Student Athlete of the Week.
And thank you, Josh. We appreciate it.
Congratulations to Josh Carter. And you got to work on that hat thing.
I do. Hey, great ball player. Real quick, we got to say goodbye. As you can see, TVAC tournament held at Cleveland Middle of the girls and boys basketball this weekend. Go see it at Seaside Bradley tonight. Cleveland Bradley in the finals
Thursday
this
night.
Weekend. And Thursday night. We'll see you. Lots of action. We'll be back next week.